This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book: A Queen's Delight by Anonymous. Chapter 1: A Queen's Delight of Conserves and Preserves, Candying and Distilling Waters. To preserve white pear plums or green. Take the plums and cut the stalk off and wipe them, then take the just weight of them in sugar, then put them in a skillet of water and let them stand in and scald, being close covered till they be tender. They must not seethe. When they be soft, lay them in a dish and cover them with a cloth, and stew some of the sugar in the glass bottom, and put in the plums, strewing the sugar over till all be in. Then let them stand all night. The next day put them in a pan, and let them boil apace, keeping them clean scummed, and when your plums look clear, your syrup will jelly, and they are enough. If your plums be ripe, peel off the skins before you put them in the glass. They will be the better and clearer a great deal to dry if you will take the plums white. If green, do them with the rinds on. To preserve grapes. Take grapes when they be almost through ripe, and cut the stalks off, and stone them in the side, and as fast as you can stone them, strew sugar on them. You must take to every pound of grapes 3/4 of a pound of sugar, then take some of the sour grapes, and wring the juice of them, and put to every pound of grapes 2 spoonfuls of juice, then set them on the fire, and still lift up the pan and shake it round for fear of burning too, then set them on again, and when the sugar is melted, boil them as fast as you can possible, and when they look very clear and the syrup is somewhat thick, they are enough. To preserve quinces white. Take a pear and core them, and to every pound of your equal weights in sugar and quince, take a wine pint of water, put them together and boil them as fast as you can uncovered, and this way you may also preserve pippins white as you do quinces. To preserve raspis. Take a pound of raspis, a pound of fine sugar, 1/4 pint of the juice of raspis. Strew the sugar under and above the raspis. Sprinkle the juice all on them. Set them on a clear fire. Let them boil as soft as is possible till the syrup will jelly. Then take them off. Let them stand till they be cold. Then put them in a glass. After this manner is the best way. To preserve pippins. Take fair pippins, and boil them in fair water till they be somewhat tender, then take them out, and peel off the skins and put them into a fair earthen pot, and cover them till they be cold, then make the syrup with fair water and sugar, seethe it, and scum it very clean, then being almost cold, put in your pippins, so boil them softly together, put in as much rind of oranges as you think will task them. If you have no oranges, take whole cinnamon and cloves, so boil them high enough to keep them all the year. To preserve fruits green. Take pippins, apricots, pear plums, or peaches when they be green. Scald them in hot water, and peel them or scrape them, put them into another water not so hot as the first, then boil them very tender, take the weight of them in sugar, put to it as much water as will make a syrup to cover them, then boil them something leisurely, and take them up, then boil the syrup till it be somewhat thick, that it will batten on a dish side, and when they are cold, put them together. To preserve oranges and lemons the best way. Take and boil them as for paste, then take as much sugar as they weigh, and put to it as much water as will cover them by making a syrup, then boil them very leisurely till they be clear. Then take them up and boil the syrup till it batten on the dish side, and when they are cold, put them up and see. An approved conserve for a cough or consumption of the lungs. Take a pound of elecampane roots, draw out the pith, and boil them in 2 waters till they be soft. When it is cold, put to it the like quantity of the pap of roasted pippins, and 3 times their weight of brown sugar candy beaten to powder. Stamp these in a mortar to a conserve, whereof take every morning fasting as much as a walnut for a week or fortnight together, and afterwards but 3 times a week. Approved. To make conserve of any of these fruits. When you have boiled your paste as followeth, ready to fashion on the pie plate, put it up into gallipots, and never dry it, and this is all the difference between conserves. And so you may make conserves of any fruits. This is for all hard fruits, as quinces, pippins, oranges, and lemons. To dry any fruits after they are preserved, to or candy them. Take pippins, pears, or plums, and wash them out in warm water from the syrup they are preserved in. Strew them over with searced sugar, as you would do flour upon fish to fry them. set them in a broad earthen pan, that they may lie one by one, then set them in a warm oven or stove to dry. If you will candy them withal, you must strew on sugar 3 or 4 times in the drying. To preserve artichokes, young green walnuts and lemons, and the elecampane roots or any bitter thing. Take any of these, and boil them tender, and shift them in their boiling 6 or 7 times, to take away their bitterness out of one hot water into another. Then put a quart of salt unto them, then take them up and dry them with a fair cloth, then put them into as much clarified sugar as will cover them, then let them boil a walm or two, and so let them stand soaking in the sugar till the next morning, then take them up and boil the sugar a little higher by itself, and when they are cold put them up. Let your green walnuts be pricked full of holes with a great pin, and let them not be long in one water, for that will make them look black. Being boiled tender, stick 2 or 3 cloves in each of them. Set your elecampane roots, being clean scraped, and shifted in their boilings 12 times, then dry them in a fair cloth, and so boil them as is above written, take half so much more than it doth weigh, because it is bitter, and see. To preserve quinces, white or red. Take the quinces, and core them, and pare them, those that you will have white. Put them into a pail of water 2 or 3 hours, then take as much sugar as they weigh. Put to it as much water as will make a syrup to cover them. Then boil your syrup a little while, then put your quinces in, and boil them as fast as you can till they be tender and clear. Then take them up, and boil the syrup a little higher by itself, and being cold put them up. And if you will have them red, put them raw into sugar, and boil them leisurely close covered till they be red, and put them not into cold water. To preserve grapes. Take the clusters, and stone them as you do barberries, then take a little more sugar than they weigh, put to it as much apple water as will make a syrup to cover them, then boil them as you do cherries as fast as you can till the syrup be thick and being cold potted. Thus may you preserve barberries or English currants or any kind of berries. To preserve pippins, apricocks, pear plums and peaches when they are ripe. Take pippins and pare them, bore a hole through them, and put them into a pail of water, then take as much sugar as they do weigh, and put to it as much water as will make a syrup to cover them, and boil them as fast as you can, so that you keep them from breaking until they be tender, that you may prick a rush through them. Let them be a soaking till they be almost cold, then put them up. Your apricocks and peaches must be stoned and pared, but the pear plums must not be stoned nor pared. Then take a little more sugar than they weigh, then take as much apple water and sugar as will make a syrup for them, then boil them as you do your pippins, and pot them as you do the pippins likewise, and see. To preserve pippins, apricocks, pear plums or peaches green. Take your pippins green and quaddle them in fair water, but let the water boil first before you put them in, and you must shift them in 2 hot waters before they will be tender, then pull off the skin from them, and so case them in so much clarified sugar as will cover them, and so boil them as fast as you can, keeping them from breaking, then take them up and boil the syrup until it be as thick as for quiddany, then pot them, and pour the syrup into them before they be cold. Take your apricocks and pear plums, and boil them tender, then take as much sugar as they do weigh, and take as much water as will make the syrup. Take your green peaches before they be stoned, and thrust a pin through them, and then make a strong water of ashes, and cast them into the hot standing lye to take off the fur from them, then wash them in 3 or 4 waters warm. So then put them into so much clarified sugar as will candy them, so boil them and put them up and see. To dry pippins, or pears without sugar. Take pippins or pears, and prick them full of holes with a bodkin, and lay them in sweet wort 3 or 4 days, then lay them on a sieve's bottom till they be dry in an oven, but a drying heat. This you may do to any tender plum. To make syrup of clove gilly flowers. Take a quart of water, 1/2 bushel of flowers, cut off the whites, and with a sieve sift away the seeds, bruise them a little, let your water be boiled, and a little cold again, then put in your flowers and let them stand close covered 24 hours. You may put in but 1/2 the flowers at a time, the strength will come out the better. To that liquor put in 4 pounds of sugar. Let it lie in all night. Next day boil it in a gallipot, set it in a pot of water, and there let it boil till all the sugar be melted and the syrup be pretty thick, then take it out and let it stand in that till it be through cold, then glass it. To make syrup of hyssop for colds.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.